Hello viewers, welcome to the IPO Connect. Today we are looking at ACME Solar Power Holdings Limited, which is hitting the market right now. I caught up with Mr. Manoj Upadhyay during the roadshow. I began the interview by asking him for his take on the growth of the solar power industry, or in fact, on the status of the solar power industry today.
Yeah, actually, solar power industry is growing because of the global need of energy transition. We are facing more and more extreme weather. To deal with, we have to really scale up, right, this whole transition. Because the whole world is moving towards that, you will see the very, very big push in this industry. I think we will be the second or third largest deployer of the renewable energy globally.
I asked Manoji whether the government and the industry are on the right track as far as the solar power sector is concerned, particularly when the government is focusing a lot on reducing dependency on fossil fuels.
On the right, the government last year has done 50 gigawatt. It's unprecedented globally. They did the 50 gigawatt of auction. And we are doing more what is called round-the-clock power, which is a true replacement of the thermal power.
Okay.
Right? You will see more and more round-the-clock power, where solar, wind and battery will get combined. Right? And this will really reduce the burden on any fossil fuel-based requirement for the government and planet. Yes, in fact, industry is in this. The good thing is I have seen one industry, similar industry, where this industry moved very fast, was the cellular industry, cellular telecom industry. In 10 years, we covered the entire India.
True.
You will see here also it is happening, but it is an entrepreneurial-driven industry.
Like in the telecom sector, does ACME see a lot of consolidation happening in the country?
Solar has already, there are 10 large people in this industry. So if you ask me, it is already happening. You will find most of the people are above gigawatt level.
Yeah.
So for example, someone with 100 megawatt may not be able to this one, their consolidation will happen.
Then the much talked about dependency on China. For long, I think the country has been dependent on China for solar panels and other products for the industry. Like we depend on China for various other products. So what is the situation now?
So first of all, I must tell you, we should thank China that they helped the industry to reduce the price to the level where solar can be compete with the normal thermal. So the first, their positive contribution.
Yeah.
But what has also happened because of this, it has become a single point of contract or single point of supply. Government of India 4 years ago started looking to set up the manufacturing here. Now we are buying from this year, all the module has to be purchased from India, and we will be very happy to purchase from the local module manufacturer. So our dependency on China has gone down significantly.
By what percentage do you think we should have come down?
60-70%.
Okay. But we still depend on China for some cell, I think.
That is a gradual process. You start with module, then you become a cell, then you go to the wafer. It's a gradual process. So we started module very well. Now we'll do the cell, and then we will do the polysilicon and wafer.
Finally, asked Mr. Upadhyay as to whether the company is looking at expanding its presence abroad.
We are doing in green hydrogen and ammonia.
Okay.
That is the new area where we are doing abroad.
Okay. Which are the countries where you
are? We started with Oman. We are constructing the green hydrogen plant in Oman.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Upadhyay.
Thank you.
Hello viewers, today we have Mr. ARUN KEJRIWAL, who is a markets expert and a strategic advisor to a lot of corporates on the market movements. Well, and welcome to the show.
Thank you, BN. Nice being on your show.
Sir, we'd like to discuss the IPO related issues of let's start with ACME Solar Holdings. What do you think are the fundamentals of the company? Are they strong enough for the investor to invest?
So, BN, we need to look at what the company does. It's a utility developer. It generates power, whether it is solar, whether it is wind, or it is a hybrid model. Now, the hybrid model is something new which is coming up in the country, where it uses the same infrastructure and different ways of generation of power, but the common infrastructure is used for evacuating power. Incidentally, wind typically gets generated from evening till morning, while solar power gets generated from sunrise to sunset. So the times for both these forms of power don't overlap whatsoever, and you are able to use the same evacuation infrastructure for using it. If we come to ACME, they have about 1300 and odd megawatt, which is already in place generating power. They have about 1700 odd, which would get commissioned in a phased manner over the next 3 to 8, 9 months. And another 1800 and odd megawatts, which would get commissioned in 12 to 18 months. Effectively, okay. 18 to 21 months from now, we are talking of a company which would have power in excess of 5,000 megawatt across various parts of the country.
So you mean to say that
if you ask
has
me,
ACME has the capability to produce power round the clock?
Not exactly round the clock, but wherever they have the hybrid capacity, yeah, they will be generating some power round the clock, while solar is the dominating power in this entire 5,000 odd that would come up. Wind is a small part, but it helps in generating power when the solar is not generating.
Okay. So is the company trustworthy from the IPO point of view?
So from an IPO, while normally one would consider the medium to long-term prospects, in India, we have a very large number of flippers who look for listing day gains. So yeah, while it doesn't sound nice to say that there may not be adequate listing gains, I would like to caution people that we are in very, very turbulent times. Incidentally, three IPOs have opened today, which is the first day of the IPO, and they would be closing together on Friday. We don't know what happens when these shares list next week on Wednesday, how the market behaves and what happens. And the impact of one listing could always impact the listing of the other two companies. So my advice to investors who are looking for listing pop, don't apply for listing pop. It may or may not be there. And if you are looking at investing in this company, your objective should be clear. It should be at least for the medium term, if not for the long term.
Medium term is how many months? 6 months, 8 months?
Very fair question. But I believe medium term should be between 12 to 15 months, because that second set of expansion that we are talking, which is a large part of that 1500, 1700 megawatt, would happen. About 500 would happen in the current year prior to March 25, and another 700, 800 would happen in the first half of FY26. So that's the reason. When, unless the scale up starts happening, you're not going to see that higher profits being generated.
Arunji, do you think the price is attractive enough?
So, looking at the pricing that has been introduced by the company, there is a large fresh issue component here. If I'm not mistaken, it's close to 2400 crores. This 2400 crores will be used to repay a large portion of the debt, which will reduce interest costs going forward. While this would definitely flow to the bottom line, it's not the saving from the interest which is the key component for this company, but the
yes.
generation of power and the sale of that power to utilities, which is important. That would kick in when the company crosses this 2000 megawatt mark, which would give them substantial margins. One other point that needs to be noted here, the key raw material for this company is cash, money.
Yeah.
It's
yes.
not anything else. The other raw material as such, if I could say, is natural, which is the rays
Free.
Of the sun, which
yeah.
is there for you to capture and utilize and convert into power. Therefore, the EBITDA margin of this company is substantially high. It's in excess of 80-odd%. This is what makes this business very, very attractive.
Also, as an industry watcher, what do you think the growth of the solar power industry as such in the country? Are we on the right track? Is the government on the right path?
So a lot has happened in the solar space. A couple of years ago, we were talking of numbers. But now when you move across the length and breadth of the company, you are able to see what's happening on the ground. Just for example, let me tell you, two months ago, we had an IPO from a company which is a large module manufacturer and also a cell manufacturer which went public, Premier Energy. Recently, 10 days ago, you had Vari Energies, which hit the market, which is also a large module player and also now entering into the cell manufacturing. So these become the principal raw material suppliers for making the equipment which somebody like an ACME would use. This clearly shows that there is all-round development happening in the solar space. It's not confined to one, two, or three activities of solar. It's five, six different activities of solar where you are finding new businesses coming in, new players entering with large capacities. So I believe we are on the right track, and solar is going to have a meaningful capacity by the time we come to 2027, 2028.
I don't think market movements, you know, depend on lots of things. They look at immediate returns, they require long-term prospects, liquidity, management, etc. But and also the sector. Do you think the power sector, solar power sector in particular, is the market mature enough to understand the structure and functioning of the sector?
So if you ask me from the listed space, this is one of the early entrants who is
yes.
coming into the sector. It's certainly a new entrant, and people would look at this company to get a sense of what's happening in this sector. The capacity that it has is reasonable to make a fair judgment of what this company will do going forward. However, it's not that large that you can replicate this company and say, okay, if we have somebody who's five times this size, revenues would be 5x and profits could be 6x. It's still some time. But I believe this is a fair example of what a solar developer company would look like. And this would give you an opportunity to get a first-hand glance at a developer in the renewable space.
So is it also, do you see it also as an opportunity to be part of the solar revolution?
Yes, BN, but like I said, if your objective is first day, first show, where you want to be out of the company, maybe at 10:30 in the morning, this may not be your best entry at solar. It's best to stay away and then look at entering this company when you believe you have a fair price, you have a track record of the company's performance. But if you are looking at a investment which could be around 12 months, it could be a fair bet to apply and hold on to the shares.
So it's a lambi horse ka, lambi race ka ghoda.
हाँ सर, लंबे रेस के घोड़े में टाइम बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट होता है और हर आदमी का जो नजरिया है लंबे रेस का, वो किसी का कुछ दिनों का होता है, किसी का कुछ हफ्तों का होता है, और
जी
मैंने यहाँ पर 12 महीने का टाइम बताया है, तो शायद कई लोग मेरी लंबी रेस के घोड़े के बात से सहमत नहीं होंगे।
ओके थैंक यू अरुण।